I've got a very long band today, which I'm going to use for working into the shoulders. If you have just got a normal length of band or a scarf, that will also work too. Okay, I'll describe what we're going to be doing as we get going. So just to begin with, roll the shoulders up and down a few times. And just notice what's going on with your body today. Okay. Let your arms rest down. Maybe your palms facing upwards is quite nice. And shutting your eyes, going inside. Okay, so try to draw your body up to a really tall seated position. And if you do struggle with this, you can always sit on a cushion, or you can sit up on a block, or at any point if you want to sit with your heels beneath you. Taking a nice long deep breath in through your nose, breathing out through your nose. Take a long deep breath in, breathing all the way back out. Take a long deep breath in, breathing all the way back out. And this time, take a longer, deeper breath in. And nodding down your chin and holding on to your breath. And then let's raise the chin back up. Breathing all the way back out again. Take a long deep breath in. Nodding down with your chin and holding on to your breath. Raising your chin back up. Breathing all the way back out again. Deep breath in. Now breathing all the way back out. Go right down to the bottom of your exhalation. Breathing out a little bit more. Lower down your chin and holding your breath out. Raise your chin back up, breathing in. And one more time, breathing out. Again, breathing out, going right down to the bottom of your exhalation. Breathing out just a little bit more, and then draw downwards with your chin, a half throat lock on. Raising your chin back up and breathing in. Breathing out. Take a deep breath in. And breathing out. And just letting that breath be nice and continuous. Letting that breath be smooth. Now clasping our fingers together and start to raise our arms high above your head, taking a deep breath in. As you breathe out, let's take a little rotation through the upper body. Breathing in, breathing to the middle. Breathing out, a little rotation through your upper body. Breathing in, bring it to the middle. Breathing out, take your hands down against the floor. Let's gently lift ourselves up onto your knees and sit ourselves back down upon your heels. into your downward facing dog. Breathing in, draw forwards to plank. Breathing out, bend your knees and sit on back. Breathing in, draw your body up and through. Breathing out, lengthening off into your downward dog. Head down, bottom up. Breathing in, draw forwards to high plank. Breathing out, bend the knees and sit back. One more time, breathing in, drawing your body up. Breathing out, send the hips back and stay for me this time. Walking your feet from one to the other. Treading it out, working your hips a little from side to side. So just notice how your body is today. Notice how that feels up into the lower back and the hamstrings, how they are responding. As you work through your practice, just try and work with kindness to yourself, listening to your body as you work through. Now let's lean the heels back and walk your hands all the way back in towards your feet. Take a hold of your elbows, let your head drop down towards your forearms. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, let the body hang. Again, deep breath in, breathe out, sink the drop a little bit further towards your feet. One more time, deep breath in, breathing out, letting go of your arms now. Slowly unroll the spine, come all the way back out to standing. Bring your arms up towards the ceiling, deep breath in. And as you breathe out, let's take a side body stretch. Tuck your tailbone slightly under, bring your arms to pull away from your body. Breathing in, drawing it up. Breathing out, pushing out into your waist. Tuck the tailbone under slightly. Breathing in, coming up. Breathing out, let go of your arms. Let's step on up to the top of your mat. Let's bring the hands in towards your heart. Taking a deep breath in, raising both arms. Breathing out, dive your body forwards. Breathing in, right leg, stepping back. Releasing your knee to the floor, lifting the chin up. Breathing out, let's step back and hold into a high plank. Breathing in, come down to your knees, your belly, your chest. Breathing out as you draw to an upward dog. Breathing in as you lower your body back. Curl the toes, engage the core. Breathing out to push the back. Back off into a downward dog. Breathing in, right foot stepping through. Lift the chin, release the toes. Breathing out, left leg softly steps through. Breathing in as you clutch through the belly. Open shoulders, chest, gaze to your thumbs. Breathing out, hands back to your heart. Breathing in, raising both arms. Breathing out, dive the body forwards. Breathing in, left leg, stepping back behind you, lifting your chin. Breathing out, let's step back and hold into a strong plank. Breathing in, down to knees, belly and chest. Breathing out, gently draw it to an up dog, no forcing. Breathing in as you lower, curl the toes, engage the core, push back. Back off into downward dog. Breathing in, left leg steps through. Lift the chin, release the toes. Breathing out, right leg steps through. Let's take a nice deep breath in, all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, hands back into your heart. Breathing in, raising both arms. Breathing up, dive your body forwards. Breathing in, right leg, step your back. Now just lay your knee down upon the floor for me. And let's just come back into a little cactus position with your arms. So I'm going to open up the palms facing forwards. I just want you to squeeze your shoulder blades towards each other. Really open up the chest. And just gazing up a little if you can. Take some deep breath here, in through your nose, out through your nose. And move it forward forwards again. Now just taking down your right hand to the floor. Lift up your right knee and push it away. And then raising your left hand and looking up. Drop down as well as you can into the front knee. Okay, really push out so the back leg is nice and straight. Now bring your hand back down to the floor. Set the feet together behind you. And then take your feet a little bit wider. Okay, so we're in a high plank. Alright. Now really lock into your core. Take some deep breaths in through your nose. Out through your nose. Now if you can, we're going to take your right hand from the floor and just tap the back of your body. And place it down. Take the left hand, take it back, tap the back of your body. Place it down. Try and keep your body completely symmetrical all the way through. Let's take your right hand to your temple and place it down. Lock the core on. Take the left hand to your temple and lock it down. All right, now bend here the elbows and lower your body to the floor. All right, that's working up the core a little bit there for you. Take the hands now underneath your chin. We're going to take a single leg to raise, and I'm going to bend the knee a little, send it back. And then draw the leg back down. Take a deep breath in, raise the left leg, sending it back a little, and drawing it back down. So not going too far too soon. Deep breath in, raising your right leg, bring the toes, send it back for a stretch into your hip. Breathing out as you come back down. So you feel the hip, okay, hip flexor, getting a little bit of a stretch in here. You'll feel also the back, okay, beginning to warm up on that reverse turning. Breathing out. Breathing in to come back. Alright, but again, this falls into the category of active stretching because we're not holding there for too long. We're just working into these movements, activity movements for the heating up and the usage of the back strength muscle. Alright, last time, got that left leg going back, breathing out, sending it over. Breathing in, coming back. Hands underneath your shoulders, gently pressing it up into your upward dog, which you're making a little bit of improvement. Then coming back on down. Curling the toes, engaging with your core, breathing in, push up to plank, breathing out into your downward facing dog. Breathing in, right foot slipping through, lifting the chin, releasing the toes back. And breathing out, left leg stepping through and folding. Breathing in, pull up through the belly, open the chest, gaze to your thumbs. Breathing out, hands back to your heart. Breathing and raising both arms. Breathing out, open the chest, folding forwards. Breathing in, left leg, stepping back. And again, taking the knee all the way down to the floor. Let's come up with the upper body. And again, palms facing forwards. Take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, let's squeeze the shoulder blades towards each other. Just really get into, you know, the action that we kind of need to do to counter all of the day's work when you're poring over your laptop, okay, you're leaning forwards. We tend to do that a lot in our work. All right, then releasing it down, taking the left hand down to the floor, curl the toes and lift the left knee up, and then raising your right arm, looking on up. And bring your hand down to the outside of your foot. Slide the feet together behind you. And then just draw down upon your knees for me. Now have your hands beneath your shoulders and your knees in alignment with your hips. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, extend your right leg out behind you and then lift it up a little. Breathing in, draw it back in and change. Breathing out, take your left leg away, point the toes, squeeze the back side, breathing in to draw back in. Good. Keep going. So right leg going away. Try and keep your hips as symmetrical as you can. Breathing into your back in. Breathing out. And try and draw the navel back to the spine. Draw the belly up underneath you. Breathing in, draw back in. Breathing out to extend the leg away. Breathing in. Now, you may want to stay with this. If we get to the next stage and you'd rather not do that today, carry on with the single leg extensions. My next offering is I take my leg away and then circle the leg. So breathing out, leg up, breathing in as it lowers. Breathing out and in. And just try to make them as smooth as you can. If you can, taking also out the opposite hand and then circling that as well. So breathing out, looking slightly ahead and really lock the core on. Breathing out and in. We pull back through the core. Last one. And then take the hand down to the floor. We're going to change sides. So take the leg away, breathing out as the leg comes up, breathing as you lower it down. Breathe out and in. And then if you're feeling good today, let's circle the arm as well. Breathing out and in. Really nice little bit of core destabilizing, well, a posture that destabilizes the body so the core works a little bit harder. Breathing out. And in. And in. Pressing it away. Looking slightly ahead of your fingers. Try not to look up underneath you. Get the last one. And relax. Okay, come down on your belly for me. I want to come into a reverse turn on your cobra. So if you take the right arm across the top, left fingers down towards the floor for me. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, rise the body up a little, look over your shoulder. And just notice what you can see today. I'm not going to worry about what we can't see, but just notice how far around you're able to see today. Just bring it all of the way back. Changing your arms over, fingertips to the floor. Take a deep breath in. Let the forearm assist you. And let the fingertips encourage you. So looking over the shoulder. Just try and relax the hips upon the ground nice and equally. Back. Okay, just imagine you're looking at your reflection. flexion from the short end of your mat, okay? Would you be able to see that back hip? Can you draw it back a little bit? Okay, take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, reverse, looking towards your left hand, right hand. And then if you can, pushing out through your straight leg and pushing into your heel and lifting your toes. Now drawing down your elbow to your knee and just wrap your arm back behind you, just looking back over your shoulder for a couple of breaths. Really open up the chest, feel the inner thigh muscles stretching. Deep breath in through your nose and through your nose. And releasing it back round. Turning your back leg now. Let the knee back down upon the floor. Let's take both hands to the inside of your foot again and now turn your front foot open. Now very, very softly bend at the elbows. If you can, channeling your gaze forwards. Moving out of the position, it seems. If you feel okay to go a bit deeper, maybe take your right hand underneath your right leg and place your foot on its edge, gently easing the body down. Tend to just get stretched out a little bit too much. Okay. Okay, so this is again working to that range of motion. Alright, now we're going to go into the diagonal, slide around the back of the head, stretch. So we're going to take it back, keeping your arms straight, all the way around, and bring it back to the front. And we're going to go the other way. Breathe in and out, and bring it back around. We're going to try and keep that head nice and still, alright? Try not to accommodate for any shortfallings you feel you've got, okay? Just maybe make the band longer if you're having difficulty keeping the arms straight. So taking it back, wrapping it around, bring it back on over. And again, take it back, wrap it around, bring it back and over. And again, take it on back. And round, last one coming up. Take it on back. Preparation of camel. Deep breath in, raise your right arm. As you breathe out, follow your hand back and down by your side. Much easier, huh? Again, deep breath in, breathing out, following the hand back and down. Alright, now if this has done something to how your body feels, maybe you feel that the back bend is a little bit more in reach. Okay, you can do more of those, more of the arm circles, or you can reach back and take your elbows and you can open up with your throat. Okay, so working into camel. So either hold on to the, you can have your hands to your lower back, supporting the lower back. You can hold on to your elbows, or you can reach back and take the back of the legs on your heels. You just take a couple of deep breaths. So, you know, part of this posture is that you're able to squeeze your shoulder blades towards each other. And then drawing the chin forwards, and slowly come on back on up. Sliding your hands ahead of you, middle fingers pointing straight up, curl the toes, and push off into your downward dog. So lengthening all the way along back body, looking up towards your tummy. Now I'm going to take the right leg up nice and high. Bend the knee, point the toe back. Then drawing down the leg and locking down the big toe, the toe next to it. Then coming forwards into a single leg plank. Looking forwards, take a nice deep breath, pulling up on your bottom ribs so that try not to dip out here. Breathe in through your nose, out through your nose. Let's bring you all the way back up. Let's go high with that leg, high down dog split. Then bring through your right knee towards your right elbow. Hold into that floating plank. Towards your left hand. Take your left heel to the floor, bring your left hand up towards the ceiling to your forward triangle. Really pulling up through your waist. Again, it's another great core exercise. Of course, again, also that strength work coming up into the right shoulder. Okay, let's take that hand down to the floor. Bring your right knee towards your right wrist and slide your back leg away. So you could take pigeon down to resting, okay? You have got a band today, so if you wanted to, just I talk through what you can do with the band. You can place it around your ankle, and then around your foot, take a hold of it, and then you can draw it towards you. So you can kind of facilitate the stretch by, you know, what will eventually be the full posture with the foot on the head. Right, then you can reach your back for it as so. It's just sometimes nice to do it. Especially if your body's nice and warm and it feels good to do that. as the band. I'm going to open it out to its full extent this time. And then from here, holding on about halfway down, and then we'll talk about how to make it harder. Taking a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, pull back through your belly, curve your lumbar spine, and stop out at halfway. Breathing in, then breathing out as we engage the core, we come back up to seated. Deep breath in, breathing out. Draw the navel back to the spine. Now, halfway is plenty, stay at halfway. If you can take your back to the floor, take it down to your shoulder blades. Breathing in. And breathing out as we slowly draw back up. Now, before you get tired, let me talk about how we can make this harder. So we can take the mat a little bit further away from the body. Okay, deep breath in. Now anytime, and as you're about breathing out, anytime you take the arms away from the central line, it's going to make it a little bit heavier. Alright, your body's going to be a little bit heavier. Deep breath in. And as you breathe out, slowly working it back, breathing in, breathing out. We're trying to just be really careful that you don't hook the shoulders up, all right? Now, I haven't talked about this for a while, but if you roll your shoulders ever so slightly, and go, okay, it's almost impossible to stiffen your shoulders and move them at the same time. Right? So you might just work out a little bit of a habit that you've got. Alright, so just moving the shoulders. It's quite hard to coordinate everything together now. Okay, and then coming up, just moving it up. But it's just, again, like I say, it's just something that you can do. If you recognize that you're a shoulder huncher, then maybe today, this is a way of taking that away. Alright, when you have finished, come up to seated. Now, I'm going to take out my left leg and leave my right foot inside of my band. Okay? From here, I'm going to lay out on my left hand side. I'm just going to swing over, so I'm facing you, but I'd like you to face along your mat so you're nice and comfortable. So when I come across, okay, the top foot has got the band around it. I'm going to place my elbow underneath my shoulder and just place my right hand on top. So it's just going to press down. Now from here, so you raise the right leg up, breathing out and then breathing into lower. Now have a little look down and I want you to see that your foot is not turning upwards. Okay, that as you lift, your toes are facing forwards. Alright, so try not to turn your toes upwards, because we want to be really, again, careful here that we're strengthening and working into the right area of the body. So your foot is flat, and pressing it down. So it may not go very high, alright? We're not looking for an impressive stretch on this, okay? We're looking to work up into the adductors and the abductors at the top of your right leg. So as you press it away, breathing out, breathing in as you lower. Shoulders back, lift the chin, keep the posture on, and in as you lower. Again, breathing out to lift, breathing in to lower. Two more there, please. Breathing out to lift, breathing in to lower. One more. Releasing that back. Okay, swing that back to a seated position and just take your hand away for a moment. Draw your legs in underneath you and gently as you pull them under, you can either step lightly back or hop lightly back. Alright, it's up to you. So, feet coming underneath, just a nice little gentle step or hop back. Push you back off into your downward facing dog. And now stepping through with your right foot and then drawing down with your left knee to the mat. Come back on up and let's take a deep breath in with your left arm. As you breathe out, bring your elbow to the far side of your knee, hands Breathing back over your right arm. Just take a couple of deep breaths. In through your nose, out through your eyes. Letting the arm down. Taking back out the left hand, so it's onto the mat again. And let's step the back foot to the top of your mat also. Let's take a nice deep breath in, all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, hands back into your heart. Take a breath in, raising both arms. Breathing out, fold the body forwards. Breathing in, right leg stepping back, left leg remaining at the front. And a deep bend into the knees, so the knees up towards your shoulder. As you bring your body up, open wide with your chest, palms facing forwards, but squeeze your shoulder blades back, keep them back, then bring them up, either look between your hands or look to your thumbs. If you can, we're looking for those arms to remain a little bit straighter. Come deeper into the knee. Breathe in through your nose, out through your nose. Now let's come out into Warrior Two, looking along the centre finger. Again, just have a little look down the body, okay? The ribs and the hips are facing the long edge of your mat. And then gazing along the centre of your left hand, rolling the left knee open. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, reverse warrior. So reaching towards your back leg, straight to the front leg, but balance on the heel if you can. And reach towards the back end of your mat. As always, when we lift and enter into this position, try to lift out of the waist. Try and lift the ribs upwards towards the ceiling. Try and relax and open the collarbone. Try and relax your shoulders and the shoulder blades downwards. And then if you feel you can, reach it back around for your heels maybe, or the back of your legs. Foot, but it can be done without a band. So if your band's not long enough, don't worry, okay? Swinging it around, okay, I'm going to swing around so I can face you still, you can see what's going on. Otherwise, just lay out along your mat. So taking my band, okay, along the floor, I'm putting my hand on top, and I'm going to slide my legs along so they line up with my body. Then from there, as you raise the top leg, breathing out, and breathing in as you lower. So as you breathe out to lift the leg, I know it's so tempting to want to take your toes up to the ceiling, but try and keep them facing forwards. Okay, it's going to be a lot more effective into the muscle usage. Breathing out to lift and breathing in to lower. So as you lift the leg, engaging with the core, breathing in as you lower. Again, breathing out, lift, breathing in to lower. Again, breathing out, press that leg away, breathing in to lower. And again, breathe out, lift. And in as you lower. Again, breathing out, press to lift, lower, keep the posture check on, shoulders back. Breathing out, press and lower. Get two more, breathing out to lift and lower. One more up and lower. Good, all right, swing your back round, take away your band. And again, another opportunity to pull under and hop back or to come up and around a different way. So pulling around, hop out into your plank, push back off into your downward dog. Stepping through with your left leg and then drawing down with your right knee, coming up into a high kneel. Deep breath in, raising your right arm. And as you breathe out, elbow coming across. You could be hands in prayer today. You could be hand down to the floor today. We're leaning forwards, lifting maybe that back knee. And then maybe we draw back over with the left hand. Take some nice deep breaths. In through your nose. Out through your nose.
Bring it back, swapping your hands over.
inside. Stay focused. In through your nose, out through your nose with your breath. Your eagle arms, either back to back with your hands or find the base of your thumb, raising your arms up through the middle. You can always just, again, if you don't feel the stretch as deeply as you once did, bring your arms forwards and then go up. And then sometimes that gives you a little bit more depth to the stretch.
Side.